Hi everyone, in this session I'd like to cover personalization slash custom report templates using the data source named database query. And I'll also use an example to demo using a connection to MCDB. So the use case, why would you want to use the database query data source, right? So it's typically used to query an external database outside of DPA in order to merge with current DPA data prior to rendering or publishing, right? So you have a report with DPA data in it, you want to add to it and then publish it, right? So merge the data into a report to provide additional data to the report. Typically data that is not available from the data protection product itself. For example, CMDB data, asset management data, etc. You can just use a simple database query data source on its own that is not merging with any other data. This will simply do an external call, grab the data from the external database, and then render it into the DPA UI. It does nothing else with it, right? That is also possible. However, whenever you use the database query data source, this does not ingest, nor save, nor copies this data into the DPA data store, right? Every time the report template runs, the database query will run and do the external query lookup on the fly at that point in time. This way, it is always current and up to date, right? So two very important points here. DPA does not store the query database data, the dates that comes back from the database query data source, right? Key elements. So even when you use the online help within the DPA UI, it is pretty extensive in explaining to you which are the supported databases. So you can see what they are on the screen and what it can do. And on top of that, you can also, in your select statement, be able to substitute variables into the select query if you need. So by passing DPA node information or start time information straight into the database query, right? So your select statement will have Java variables surrounded by at signs. So pretty powerful technique. So let's go back to the database query parameters. So before you start using the database query data source, you will need to know the type of database you are reading from or wanting to connect to, the actual database server name, right? And the port that is listening for the query. You will also need to know the name of the database. And of course, you'll need a username password into that database, and TIPIT and DPA only does read only. So it's preferred to have a read only credential. The actual query, a select statement of sorts, right? So whoever owns that database, like CMDB or asset management folks, they will construct the query for you because they know their database best and they know which is the optimum query to use, right? Sure, you can struggle on your own, but you might create a very inefficient, poor performing query. And the last one is keys. Which of the fields returned by that select statement, you want as keys. You can have one or more, all right? And before you do this in DPA, I like to test it with a third party freeware tool called DBeaver. If DBeaver can connect to it, then DPA's database query will be able to connect to it as well, right? Just a little check so that you know whether a DPA is having an issue or is it just a normal connection issue, okay? Cool. Let us try that out. So, create custom report template, add the data source. I'm just going to quickly filter format the database query. There we go. Right, remember you can hit view source description to see those online help files. I'll just select it for now. I'll highlight this. We'll go straight to the parameters field, right? And you can see here, I've already populated it with Postgres. I'm connecting to an Avamar server. I'm connecting to that Avamar server's MCDB, which is open on port 5555. And I've created a username password that's read-only to the MCDB with the name of DPA with a password. And let's say there is a view there called V underscore audits. I'll do a select star from V audits, right? And I'm not sure what the fields are right now, so I'll just put something in. And if I go to fields, you'll see that it automatically populates immediately. If the fields populate here, you know that the query did work. If the query did not work, the section will be empty, okay? So you now I can select to set or elect to choose include all, for example. Now that I know the field names, I might want to use something like username as a key. And I'm specifying it as a key because it may help me with merging data to another data source after the fact. Right now, it won't make a difference, right? So I'm just testing this external lookup to see if it'll work. I'll link it to the end. Now to preview it, you can actually select any object you want because the database query, there's only one data source that does an external lookup. So it's not going to matter what node you choose or what time frame you choose. It's going to do the lookup right now. Okay. So typically with select star queries, it is very inefficient because I'm actually asking to retrieve all rows, right? So this will take a little while. And there you have it, right? There's some sample data there to 250 rows. DPA does cap it. So it knows that if you're trying to do a select star type query and your preferences use the default of 250 rows, it'll only bring back 250 instead of going and grabbing a million, right? So this will at least give you a preview, an idea of what data there is in this table and what you might want to be collecting or filtering for, right? And let's say, for example, there was a chap who wanted to know what type of logins there were to Avamar, right? So I could do something like this. I could construct a SQL select statement that will do exactly that, right? So now that I know the fields in this table, I can do something like this. Select a distinct username, object, operation, date, and time from V audits, where the object is user, the operation is logon, and order it, right? So in other words, I'm looking for any users who've logged in to Avamar. Okay. So if I go back to my design and I change the query, you see, it reset and changed the fields. It actually tried the query, changed the field list. And if I go into the preview, run it again. So now you can see I have a username, which is a user, or object type user, and it did a logon at this particular date, particular time, right? So I could filter this by distinct username to find all users that log into Evermar, right? Let's do that. So let's say select distinct user underscore name from the underscore audits. That is all I want. I want just a list of names. And it doesn't matter if it's user logons, MCC alike, issues, things like that, right? Cool. Give it a sec to check it out. There we go. And then I go to preview. Test it again. Right, so it picked up MC user and root. So this is a small test lab system, and that's all I've got in here. Right. Cool. So you can see that this demonstrates how database query can go outside of DPA to grab external data into DPA itself, but only for rendering purposes, right? This data that I just retrieved does not get stored into the data store. So now you can give this report a name, you can schedule it, to run every morning at 9 o'clock and email someone if you wish, right? So just a note, for me to access the MCDB in this particular case, I did have to do some tweaks to on the Evermar system to allow multiple remote accesses to the MCDB itself, right? But it is possible. Hope that helps. Cheers.